Yeah, I know, I did miss this part of the story yesterday, but I did see this update pop up in my newsfeed, and upon seeing it, the realization to me came that this was actually a really good opportunity to talk about this player. Now, why exactly is it a great opportunity? Well, it's because I haven't spoken about this player in literally almost a full year when it comes to Detroit Red Wings prospects. The guy we're talking about here today is Joe Veleno, the other Detroit Red Wings top round pick in the 2018 NHL Entry Draft. He's a guy who is also in the news because, like the guy we talked about yesterday, Filip Zadina, who also happened to be taken in the 2018 first round, Veleno is apparently on his way to the Czech Republic, which is included in the Zadina story, but because I missed that detail out yesterday, I didn't actually mention his name up until today. Let's go over onto MLive.com and read the article they have over here. It speaks about how Filip Zadina and Joe Veleno may start the season for 2020-2021 in the Czech Republic. Word is, it's the same team, the Oceláři Třinec Hockey Club out of the Czech Extraliga, that's trying to get both Zadina and Joe Veleno to play for their team starting the next season, pretty much. Again, if you missed out on this yesterday, Zadina's father is the assistant coach for this team, and according to Steve Yzerman, it does appear that going over to the Czech Republic isn't something that he's against. Instead, it's actually something that he's quite for. This is because having your prospects play games is better than having them not play games, and in a pro league where you can actually get some experience against men, get your feet wet a little bit, and actually tune yourself up before coming back to Detroit in November for training camp, it seems like a very good opportunity, and that seems to be the case here. Detroit would be sending over these two players to the Czech Republic, and once the season comes back, they will be recalled. That seems to be the plan here, and we noted it in yesterday's video. The only reason it hasn't been done is because there are insurance issues that need to be sorted out before a contract like this could be signed. But if all goes according to plan, we will most likely see Zadina and Joe Veleno suiting up for the Oceláři Třinec Hockey Club coming in, let's just say, September, maybe October. But the reason I said this was a great opportunity to talk about Joe Veleno is because Joe Veleno is just that, a Detroit Red Wings prospect who, in my opinion, still holds a very good deal of value. So because we got the news part out of the way, the going away to the Czech Republic thing out of the way, let's treat the rest of this 7-minute gameplay as somewhat of a what's next, 1 year later kind of thing. I only say kinda because 1 year later doesn't make sense because this guy wasn't drafted in 2019. The 1 year later series is focused on players drafted in 2019. But the way I want to approach this commentary is similar in that kind of fashion. Joe Veleno was drafted by the Detroit Red Wings 30th overall in the 2018 NHL Entry Draft. Now, heading into this draft, Joe Veleno was a guy who many people thought could go upwards of somewhere in the top 10, and other people said he probably would drop down a lot because he was a bust. A lot of people called him a bust back then, before he was even drafted. Back in the 2018 draft, he was ranked 10 by ISS, 14th by Future Considerations, 37th by Hockey Prospects, 10th by McKean's, 14th by TSN and Bob McKenzie, and he slipped all the way down to 30th. In fact, the Red Wings didn't even take Veleno with their own pick. They took him with the Vegas Golden Knights pick. Yeah, you know, one of the three picks that Vegas gave up in order to acquire Thomas Tatar at the trade deadline in their inaugural season. But Joe Veleno was a guy who some people had him going early, some people had him going late, because his reputation built him up as somebody who should have been a number one, number two, number three caliber prospect in this draft. I say that because Joe Veleno was the very first player to receive exceptional status in the QMJHL. In the CHL, he was not first. In fact, there were a few guys ahead of him, Tavares, Ekblad, McDavid, Sean Day, etc. You get the point here. But exceptional status is something that was given to Veleno that allowed him to play in the QMJHL at 15 years old, when the normal age of entry is normally 16. And because he was an exceptional status player, people said all the way back in 2016, yo, look out for this guy, he could be first overall in the 2018 NHL Entry Draft. But as the years went on, we didn't see the same John Tavares, Connor McDavid-like production out of Joe Veleno. Instead, we saw a few up and down years, some years where he was okay, some years where he kind of trailed off, where he had similar points per games. There wasn't really a huge upwards progression for Veleno until after he was drafted and after he was traded to the Drummondville Voltigeurs. But Veleno, to me, even all the way back in 2018, was a guy that I still saw tremendous value in. Not because he wasn't Connor McDavid, but because what he was a very reliable two-way center whose skating and passing was so elite that you weren't supposed to expect a Connor McDavid-like player out of this kind of guy. The exceptional status label kind of misled everybody into thinking that Joe Veleno would be a Connor McDavid or John Tavares-like player. But because the production wasn't there, people kind of said, oh no, the guy's not that good, he's a bust. Look at him, he's just a point per game in his draft year, what kind of guy is this, huh? But I remember this point very vividly back in Andy LaHue's video, and this is one of my favorite videos that Andy LaHue has ever done, one of my favorite videos on prospects in general on YouTube. Because back in that video, which was made before the 2018 draft, Andy talks about how Joe Veleno, despite the fact that he is not super highly touted franchise generational-like potential like Connor McDavid is, the fact is, he was so mature, so poised, and so polished to the point where the QMJHL guy said, yeah, you know, this guy's good enough to play in the league a year early than when he's supposed to be able to play. Let's give him exceptional status. And the way he plays is just so well-oriented that stylistically, people said that Veleno played his game the same way that Jonathan Toews does. A good work ethic, strong two-way game, really nice skating, and an elite passing ability. Sure, the ceiling may not have been exactly the same as a Jonathan Toews, but the fact that Joe Veleno was able to find a very good and stable home in the QMJHL is a testament to the fact that he does most likely have top 6 potential in the NHL, just because of the safety attached to his game and how good he is able to play hockey. So the fact that this guy was ranked as high as number 10 by some scouting outlets, but he dropped to the Red Wings at 30, was an absolute steal to me, and for the most part, a big surprise to everybody. And after his draft year in his draft plus one, he was over a point per game by far for the Drummondville Voltigeurs. 104 points in 59 games played. My goodness. He totally showed the entire QMJHL that, yeah, even though this guy is not supposed to be a Connor McDavid-like guy, he can still put up points. And then eventually he went to the Grand Rapids Griffins this past season, starting the season off as a 19-year-old, where he was just under half a point a game. He was a minus 25, which certainly will need some polishing up, but of course plus minus isn't the be-all and end-all, and he had a crazy good World Juniors as well. So Joe Veleno, the fact that he's only 20 years old, and he's already developed at such a mature pace to where he's already a suitable pro hockey athlete, it's built a profile of this prospect that says to many people that he could potentially challenge for a roster spot next year on a depleted Red Wings team. Make no mistake about it, I am a huge believer in Joe Veleno. If you don't believe me, even all the way back in 2018, back before the entry draft, I made a video talking about why I wanted this guy for the Vancouver Canucks. And the thing is, the Canucks in that draft were picking at 7th overall. So the fact that I could personally justify in my head taking this guy at 7 when he dropped to 30 kind of in itself tells the whole story on how I feel about Joe Veleno. But taking a look at what he's going to be able to do next season in the Czech Republic for the hockey club Oceláři Třinec alongside of Filip Zadina, oh man, that's a vision that I absolutely love to think about, because Veleno, despite being defined as a two-way forward, has some incredible vision and passing. He could be a very solid playmaker when he wants to be, and if you have this guy alongside of a Filip Zadina, then man, things could get crazy in the Czech Republic. So talk to me in the comments below what you think about Joe Veleno and his path. What do you think about him going to the Czech Republic? I personally am very, very, very for it. With the uncertainties of the AHL, I would just rather see him play hockey games anywhere than not play hockey games. But let me know what you think in the comments below. I hope you enjoyed this video. Search of the Trolls 99. And bye.